Tamara Stark from the Bethel Park Community Center. Today, with my Tai Chi class, we're going to work on rollback and press on the diagonal from Carry Tiger to the mountain. And I'm going to show you all the way to single whip on the diagonal, because the other week we worked on fist under the elbow. So it goes into fist under the elbow, for all of you that understand that. And if you don't understand Tai Chi, it doesn't matter, to go ahead and try these postures. And I'll tell you the principles as we go, because that's what makes Tai Chi not just dancing across the floor. So all the principles are always the same. So so let's get started. So for me to start, I'm going to actually face away from you, but I'm going to be turning towards you and then back away from you again. So from cross hands, I'm going to show you Carry Tiger to the mountain. And mostly I want to show you the feet, because you mostly want to have your feet shoulder width apart. And this posture is a big step, and you want to step with your feet shoulder width apart from this diagonal. So in order to always take a step in Tai Chi, you have to sink your weight into one leg so that you're rooted, so that your other leg is empty. This leg is full, so you can pick this foot up and step wherever you want in Tai Chi without moving. So to relax and sink. So your feet are going to be shoulder width apart. We're starting from cross hands, which is the 14th posture, the end of the first third. So your feet shoulder width, your toes pointing straight. You don't want your toes here. That tightens your back. So everything is relaxed. You're going to sit slightly. So you have, as if you're sitting in a chair, your sacrum's hanging. So not here. So in order to relax and sink your weight down, not to be top heavy, you test to have your hips level to the floor. So all your weight is on your left leg. So you're relaxing, sinking into your left leg. Right hand is on the outside, left hand's on the inside. This is called cross hands. So not here, but here. So relax your shoulders. So from here, you're going to turn. Your hands are going to come down. Right hand is turned, left hand is on top. So see how my left hand is on my right wrist. So I didn't shift my weight, I just turned. My weight's still on my left leg. So from here, my right leg and my left hand move simultaneously. So my left hand is parallel to the floor, facing the cardinal direction. Still my weight on my left leg. So no weight on my right leg. So I'm stepped shoulder width wide from this direction. So if you look at my heels, they should be shoulder width wide. So what you don't want to do, because then you've lost your root. So keep your root, don't try to step too far. What you're trying to do is step this direction, not that direction. So your hands come down as you turn. Right hand turns, left hand on top. You're facing the diagonal. Now as you shift your weight, see my right hand is protecting myself. My left hand is facing the cardinal direction, but not to hang on. So you want to relax, let go. Let your wrist be straight. Drop your elbow. Shift your weight. So now I'm 70% on my right leg. My right hand came to my right knee because I shifted. I didn't move my hand. I just shifted my weight. So So now my weight is on my right leg. I can raise my toe. So as I turn, my right hand is coming as like a brush knee and turning over, and my left hand's coming slightly forward. So that's carry tiger to the mountain. So from here, your feet, your heels should be shoulder width apart, which means here. And your weight, 70%, 30%, right hand brushed your knee, turned over, left hand came slightly forward. So from here, that's carry tiger to the mountain. So you're going to shift your weight, right hand comes up, left hand comes near under your elbow. So I didn't turn, just a shifting. So from here, that's what's moving my hands, is I'm shifting from 70% to 100%. So keep your nose and navel lined up, not to turn your head, not to look at your hand. So your nose and navel stay lined up. So 100% on your left leg, turn. That makes my right hand come in front of my chest. My left hand swings out. So right here, so from right here, I'm not stretching out, but I'm relaxed. I'm facing this direction, my nose navel lined up. So then as I'm shifting my weight, my left elbow drops down. I'm going to turn back to press. So let me show you that again. So your feet don't move. So from carry tiger to the mountain, to roll back, and press. So you're back to 70-30 again. So try not to tighten your shoulders, to become top heavy, to make it hard, but the more that you can relax your shoulders, sink your weight, relax your sacrum, relax your toes, don't grip onto the floor. So that's roll back and press on the diagonal. So from here, to separate your hands, as you're shifting your weight, drop your elbows. Then shift back to push on the diagonal. So again, your feet don't move. Not to come up and down, but to stay at the same height. Your legs might start to feel it. And that's good. If you're up here, that's not Tai Chi. You have to relax and sink, stay at the same height. There's no momentum when you're here. You're not coordinated with your body. When you relax and sink, you can feel that your hips move your arms. So you can feel the momentum. If you're up here, it's not there. So you don't want to push yourself too much and to sit, but to relax. If you push yourself, then it becomes really hard. So there's that fine line, just relax. So from carry tiger to the mountain, to roll back and press. So I don't move my arm so much as my hips move my arm. So my left arm, if I don't use my right arm, I'm just letting my hips kind of move my arm. So right at the end, your left hand is going to turn palm away so that you can come to press. So from press, as soon as you start to shift your weight, move your hands. So you can't move your hands and then shift your weight because there's no coordination there. There's no relaxing and sinking. So Tai Chi is a moving meditation. There's no meditation when you do this. So to try to, as soon as you start to shift, turn your right hand, palm down, separate your hands, let your elbows drop, then push back to 70-30. So from press, shift your weight, turn your right hand, palm down, separate your hands, shoulder width apart, drop your elbows. Now I'm 100% on my left leg. Then I'm going to push. See how my hands come slightly up. So I'm not pushing. So even though in Tai Chi, if you continue taking Tai Chi, you can push somebody across the floor with just that much push. If you use this much push, then they can push you. So you always have to relax. Always let your hips rule. So from here, to always relax your shoulders. See how my shoulders relax back. I'm not going to come back up here. They're just going to relax and they're just going to come with me. But they're not going to go beyond my knee. So I'm not pushing. I'm just using the strength here. Here. So from press, so the strength is in your hips. Then you're going to shift your weight, let your arms become a little bit more straight, raise your toe. So I'm 100% here. Now I can turn. So I'm turning to the diagonal. So if you see my feet, my left foot is turned toward the diagonal. I mean my right foot. My left foot is still facing straight. So facing the diagonal, all my weight on my left leg. Now I'm going to shift my weight to my right leg, slightly turn to the right. So I'm going into single whip on the diagonal. So I'm not facing the diagonal anymore, I'm facing slightly to the right. My right wrist hanging, my fingers and my thumb barely touching. So not to hang on, because you'll tighten your shoulder and your weight will go up and you won't be able to take the next step. So you're constantly reminding yourself to relax, 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 relax. So from here, as I'm shifting, that brings my arm over. So I'm not just bringing my arm over, it's because I'm shifting. And that brings my right hand in. So I'm 100% on my right leg, I'm facing slightly to the right of the diagonal. 100% of my right leg. So don't grip onto the floor, relax and sink. Always think about where your weight is. Is it on your toes? Is it on your heels? Is it on the right side of your foot? The left side of your foot? All those things can get you off balance. If you can have your weight right in the center of your foot, then you can relax. If I'm off to the right, I have to tighten up. If I'm on my toes, I'm tightening up. If I'm on my heels, I'm tightening up. But if I can find that spot, I can sink down and relax. So now I can raise my heel of my left foot. As I raise my heel, I'm going to turn. My right hand comes out. And now I'm facing the cardinal direction. Still all my weight's on my right leg. So from here, you want to take a step shoulder width apart. And have your toe facing the diagonal. As you're shifting, your left hand's going to come up in front of your chest when your knee is at your toe. Then you can raise your toe of your right foot and to turn, and turn your left hand palm away as you're turning toward the diagonal. So When you end, your right foot is facing the cardinal direction, left foot's facing diagonal. Your weight is 70% on your left leg, 30% on your right leg. But you can check yourself by coming back and turning and see if your feet are shoulder width. Those two steps carry Tiger to the mountain and single whip on the diagonal are very similar. They're opposite. So, like I said, the idea is not to step as far as you can step. The idea in Tai Chi always is to relax, sink, keep your balance, and take a step. So it doesn't matter where you're going to step in Tai Chi, but you want to keep your balance the whole time. So you can take all these steps and just relax and always be balanced. So if my weight is a little forward, I can't do that. If it's back, I can't do that. So to relax, feel as if you have a line from the top of your head to the center of that foot. So all the while that you're practicing any posture, relax your foot, relax your toes, know where your weight is. Okay, so like I said, wherever you want, whatever step you're taking, don't lose your balance. Know where your weight is to relax and sink. So we'll start from press. So from press, as you're not going to come up and down. If you come up, you tighten your shoulders, your neck. So you're always going to be relaxed. So moving and relaxing is a lot harder than it looks. So constantly to remind yourself. Always you want your wrists straight. If your wrists are bent slightly, it tightens your shoulders. So if your wrists are straight, you can relax and sink. If you're holding your breath, you can't relax and sink. So all these are principles. And in class, I will tell you the principles over and over and over and over. You don't have to memorize them. You just will start hearing them in your head. So from facing the diagonal, from press. So not here. Not here. But here. Relax your sacrum. Relax your chin. So shifting, turn your right hand, separate your hands, drop your elbows. And then shift again, but not to come up high or stay at the same height. So your fingers should not be beyond your knee. Then come back again. Turn. So right now I'm facing the diagonal, all my weight on my left leg. Slightly turn to face slightly to the right. Your right hand, not here, but relax your shoulder. Relax your fingers. Let your wrist just hang. So not to hang on with your wrist. Let your left hand just be loose. And let's come palm up under your fingers. Another posture, I have already explained this, but as if this were a bird's beak. You want to relax, and this is the bird's beak. Your fingers and your thumb barely touch, and they're right above the center of your palm. So if the bird had taken a drink of water, the drop from the bird's beak would land in the center of your palm. So that's where you want your left hand. So you want your right hand to face the diagonal. You're not here, not here. Because this is a strike. So your hand is going to face the direction that you're striking. All my weight is on my right leg. Now I can raise my heel. So when you raise your heel, not to come up, not to lose your balance, not to change where the weight is on your right leg. So just be able to raise your heel. And then as you turn, you're going to turn on the toe. Now I'm facing the cardinal direction. So not to let your hand come out before you turn, not to turn and then put your hand out, but try to make everything simultaneous. So to turn. Then you're going to take a step to the diagonal shoulder width. From here, when you shift your weight, your shoulder width from this direction again, when you shift your weight, your left hand comes up. So let your left hand come up. Your left hand, the palm of your left hand, is facing your sacrum. I mean your chest. So you're protecting yourself. This is a very vulnerable place here. So you don't want your hand to go over here. And sometimes you can work on something as simple as that, you know, to try to make everything move simultaneously. So if you're worried about being coordinated, Tai Chi will help you to become coordinated. So my right hand is facing the diagonal. I'm shifting my weight. My knee is to my toe. I'm going to raise the toe of my right foot, and I'm going to turn on the heel. So as I turn, my foot is just going to face the cardinal direction. And my left hand's going to turn palm away simultaneously. So just this turn, relax, sink. So try not to hang on and turn. It's not an easy turn. It looks easy, but it's not. So not to come up and hang on, but to stay relaxed. So let me start from the very beginning again and go through it one more time from this angle. So we're starting with cross hands. Your feet shoulder width facing straight. I'll just go through it and I won't say anything. I can actually do it better without talking, because when I talk, my weight goes up. So to relax, sink, know where your weight is. Let me do it one more time. I'll do it where I'll tell you the shifting and the turning, if it's shifting and turning or shifting and turning. So all your weight on your left leg, feet shoulder width parallel. So this is just a turn. Shifting and turning. This is just shifting. This is just turning. Didn't shift my weight. Shifting and turning. This is just shifting, not turning. Shifting. Shifting. Turn, not shifting. So my weight's still on my left leg. Shifting and slightly turn. All my weight on my right leg. Just a turn. Shifting. Turning. Okay. Okay, well, I hope you all are safe and well and staying home. Remember to breathe through your nose, in and out through your nose. So we'll see you next week.